Good afternoon, Whitehall. You guys can do better than that. Good afternoon, Whitehall. All right, our fourth graders, we have a really nice concert assembly to give you today. So let's give our fourth graders a big round of applause. So, before we begin, let's remember to be a polite, respectful audience, right? So we're sitting crisscross applesauce, not kneeling. Crisscross applesauce so that everybody can see behind us. Thank you for fixing it. If you're not crisscross applesauce, thank you, sir. And we are going to listen so we can hear. And you know what? They're gonna teach us a little bit about the holidays this December. Just like we've been singing songs in music class to learn all about the holidays we celebrate in our culture, okay? So you ready for a nice concert? How do you show thanks? How do you give thanks? Show me now. All right, very good. Here we go. Here's the fourth grade chorus, winter concert.
There's so much going on everywhere around town.
Plus, we get so much time off. I'm really looking forward to Christmas break.
Wait a minute, not everyone celebrates Christmas, you know.
Yes, there are lots of other holidays in December.
Funny you should mention that. I just saw some of the most unusual candle holders in a store on Main Street the other day. One held 9 candles, one held 7, and then the clerk told me that some paper bags in the window also had sand and candles inside. I've never seen anything like them.
Can anyone explain?
Well, let's start with the first one, the one that holds 9 candles.
I know, that's the menorah. It's a symbol for Hanukkah, a Jewish holiday that takes place in December.
But doesn't that last for 8 nights?
Why 9 candles? The middle candle, called the shamash, is used to light each of the other candles and is lit every night.
Let's celebrate the miracle of Hanukkah!
now fill me in with a little paper bag. They really interest me. What is that all about?
Back in the 16th century, Spanish people began celebrating Christmas by reenacting Mary and Joseph's search for a room at an inn or posada in Bethlehem.
This Hispanic tradition has evolved into an event, as guests go from house to house asking for a place to stay.
They are turned away just as Mary and Joseph were. More guests join in the search and are turned away again.
Well, finally they come to a home where the pathway is lit by luminaries. Those little candles and bags held down by a bit of sand inside. In this house, they are welcome.
Is that where the piñata comes in?
Yes, that's when the singing, dancing, and celebration begins.
Which holds a candle for each of the 7 days of Kwanzaa. The family gathers each night to light a candle and talk about the special principle and Nguza Osaba of that day.
What are those 7 principles?
Umoja, unity in the family, community, nation.
Self-determination, deciding things for ourselves, speaking for ourselves.
Ujima, working together and responsibility to make life a better for our community.
Ujamaa, cooperating to build and support our businesses.
Nia, purpose, a reason for living.
Kuumba, creativity, using our minds and our hands to leave our community more beautiful.
Imani, faith, believing in ourselves, our people, and our future.
The traditions of Hanukkah, La Fiesta de la Posada, and Kwanzaa. Here's the test. What do you think of when I say the word Christmas?
Greeting cards.
Presents.
Lots of snow.
Holly.
Ivy.
Mistletoe.
Elves.
Reindeer.
Ho ho ho.
Christmas tree.
Stockings.
Lights that glow.
Merry Christmas!